Oh, look. There's a concert in the park tonight.
That's nice.
What a lovely idea. Ned, why don't we go?
Go where?
Classical music in the park. We could have Reginald pack us a lovely picnic basket with caviar, champagne.
Katherine, I think you're forgetting something.
What?
Well, a park is a public place. They'll let anyone in.
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, don't tell me that Katherine Bell Ashton wants to sit on the ground with whatever riffraff happens to wander in off the streets. I thought you made it your life's mission to remove yourself from all that.
That is a nasty thing to say.
I'm sorry.
Why don't you just stop pulling the punches, Ned? You're ashamed of me. You're embarrassed to be seen with me in any other setting besides business or eating a meal. I am sorry that I brought it.
Katherine. I guess I could have handled that better.
L&B Records.
Yes, I'd like to speak with Elle, if that's possible.
May I ask what it's regarding?
Yes, I'd like to tell her just how very much I love her. And I'd like to know exactly what she's doing tonight so I can keep that image throughout what promises to be a horrendously tedious business meeting.
Well, Mrs. Main is going to be extremely busy, probably right through the night. She's going to be editing the mellifluous tones of her much-adored husband all by herself in a lonely old studio. Want to come and watch?
Oh, I wish I could.
Oh, then make your wish come true. Dump your silly meeting. You said it yourself, it's probably going to be as boring as you can get. And if it's with those jokers who were here last night, you'd be lucky if you stayed awake.
It's no contest. I'd rather be with you. But,
unfortunately, I know.
Have I ever told you that you are the most patient and understanding wife a man could possibly ask for?
No. But maybe you should.
I just did.
Call me later if you get a break.
I will. Love you.
Love you more.
Katherine, about that picnic.
Don't do that.
What are you guys doing here?
We're on an official kidnap mission.
Huh? Just stop whatever you're doing because you're coming with us.
Where am I going?
A concert in the park.
It's been scientifically proven that if you limit your intake to one type of music, little brain cells start exploding in your head.
It's not a pretty sight.
And the only way to avoid it is to broaden your musical horizons with one dose of culture, which means you're coming with us.
No, I can't because I am working.
No. As senior partner, I am pulling rank. Last thing I need is my one and only producer with her brain cells exploding.
It may be dawning on you right about now that we're not about to leave without you.
All right. Okay. I would love to go. All right. But no, first I gotta change. Okay. So
yeah,
why don't you guys go on without me and I'll meet you there. Hey, you think there are gonna be fireworks? Cause I love fireworks.
You
good. Okay.
Honey?
Yes? Let me tell Miguel about Lily, please.
Brenda, can you give us a rest? You're making my eyes hurt.
Listen, Miguel is my friend. He's our friend.
Uh-huh.
And he would be so excited if he knew about Lily.
Which is exactly why you gotta keep your mouth shut. What if Lily blows it off? You want to build Miguel's hopes up when there's a chance he can get shot down? Huh?
Can I tell Lois?
Out of the question.
I hate keeping secrets. You always have to remember who knows what and who's keeping secrets.
So, my partner is the keeping secrets from me.
Somebody else's business, you understand?
Yeah.
guess so, but I'm with Brenda. I hate secrets. I mean, trust is the foundation upon which you build friendships, right? And secrets assume a lack of faith in the other person.
Not all the time. Well, I mean, when it's not your secret to tell, right? I mean, remember when you told me that you couldn't tell me that thing about Miguel? You know, he said that he was having problems with his manager in Puerto Rico. Well, you couldn't tell me, right? Because it was his secret. And he asked you not to, so...
Yeah.
You're right. See?
You're right. Okay, I stand corrected. You know, I am really so psyched that you guys, like, dragged me out of the house for this, you know? It's just that...
What?
I kind of wish Eddie could be here, you know?
Yeah, I wish he could be here, too, so I could see him sometimes.
I know. I want him to finally meet you. Every time, it seems like you two just miss each other. Every single time. Ooh. It smells like brown sugar. Can you get the tapioca?
No, I don't like this stuff. Get
out of here. Oh, come on.
I don't like it.
Have some.
Hey, you want this?
No. Thank you, Sonny. You crazy or what?
You guys, I think I'm going to go get some water. My head is feeling really weird right now.
Brent, are you okay? Come on. Oh, Brenda!
Brent, are you all right? Brenda, are you okay? Are you all right?
Maybe we should call 911.
No. Wait. I think she's coming out of it. Brent?
What happened?
You fainted, honey. You all right?
Yeah. Wait, you're not pregnant, are you?
No, I feel really weird, though. I don't feel good.
It's okay. I'm not
okay.
Come on, babe.
Wait!
It's okay.
Come on.
I think I just need to go home.
No,
I don't feel good at all.
Okay. No. Look, give me a minute, okay? Let me just pack this stuff up, okay? Just wait right for a second.
Would you hurry up?
Yeah. Here. All right, let's go. Hold her up, Sonny.
You got it.
You okay, Bren? You feeling better? Are you sure you're all right? Huh?
All right.
Come on.
Come on.
Right. Okay. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry.
My goodness, is something wrong?
Oh, hey, Mrs. Q. No, Brenda, she had a little fainting spell is all.
How are you feeling, dear?
I feel better now. I think maybe it was just stress or something.
Oh, I'm so sorry, dear. Well, you just relax.
I'm so stressful about a picnic in the park.
No, I drank some water. I think I'll be okay now.
Okay, is this cold enough?
Yes.
I must say, you are extremely unpredictable.
Is that a bad thing?
I think it's wonderful.